Hey guys, it's me Tazzy and welcome back to another video. What a year 2017 has been. Though painful in some cases, still great in others. A year full of growth, development and most importantly, fun. A year which has made me a better person in so many ways and a year that has shown me what it truly means to be a YouTuber in Australia. Before we dive into the brand new year, let's go back. It's time to rewind all the way back to the start of 2017. This year started like so many others with goals, three to be precise. The first was to hit 150 subscribers. We didn't hit that goal, but I can live with that because we ticked off the others. Two was to hit 15,000 channel views, which we smashed into 22,851,000 channel views. And the last was to make better content, which I believe we have, by getting better equipment, learning much more, getting a job and taking all the opportunities as they come around. I don't think I regret much of 2017. It's been a great year. Pretty close to this, I got my university offer, into paramedicine at ACU. But to say I was surprised that I got it is the understatement of the year. As this meant the end of my high schooling for good, I closed off the year-long series Vlogger VC student and went to focus on other stuff instead. By focusing on other stuff, I mean gaming and vlogging. I started building houses in The Sims 4 and did a gaming series on Assassin's Creed 2. After this, I made a video about how to clean your room, which had a surprising amount of views on it. I cleaned my room, my desk, did some organization, got everything set so I could make proper videos for you guys. I also went on my first ever Melbourne YouTuber meetup. It was in Melbourne, so naturally I got lost. Duh. I met a ton of cool people, some of which I would get to know and learn from exponentially throughout the year. I'd like to thank so many of you, but I can't, so I'm only just going to mention one. Kirk Donaldson, you're the man, your expertise are amazing and your cinematic stuff is epic. Thank you for guiding me so much in the last year. Hopefully I can continue to learn from you throughout this year. Going to the Avalon Air Show was absolutely epic and it started sort of the first part of working as recordings of cadet activities and being part of the social media as well as editorial side of my squadron. This included one of the videos I am most proud of from the year, and that was my Anzac Day video, a collection of photos and videos from multiple services from Anzac Day to one of the greatest Australian songs. A few small gaming stuff happened in between, more Assassin's Creed, more Sims builds, but also finding out that I'm a Gryffindor, yes! And playing on Club Penguin for the last day ever before it got shut down. Then all of a sudden I got a call. A job interview with Ted's Cameras and my first ever reply to any of the 57 resumes I sent out. You're talking to the kid that got knocked back from Macca's, KFC, Red Rooster and Hungry Jack's all in one hit. I mean, I've got a gift, clearly. After a scary and nerve-wracking interview, a call came through saying that I got the job. My first day included being late and everything that could go wrong going wrong. But what I got out of it was so much knowledge and some good friends too. Plus an income, which would come in later on in the year. Another YouTube meetup saw me catch up with some more amazing people and some interesting singing went down. I may have done vocal in high school, but I don't think Bougainville was what my teacher had in mind.
End of the day, we're just trying our best. Room to improve, you bet, because although we have it good, let's help our neighborhood. We really are a Bougain place, a loving but a Bougain place, a cringy level Bougain place.
Around May, I won a competition through a mate named Kayser Reveal, and basically, I won a brand new mic, the Blue Snowball. I currently use this mostly for gaming, but some voiceovers, and I officially no longer have a really bad crackling that came with my old pair of Sennheisers.
Hey guys, it is me Tazzy, and welcome back to another video.
As we progressed through the year, I did renovations to my room, passed my hazards test for driving, and also got a stand for that same mic. Towards the end of June, I announced something special, something that I've been waiting to get on for 4 years. That's eight? 4 years! And I finally got on it. That was a cadet promotion course, or junior non-commissioned officers course with my Australian Air Force cadets. I'd been waiting so long to get on this, and I finally got on it. Naturally, I met tons of awesome people. Had some really stupid things happen, some tough moments, and an epic graduation parade. One of the proudest moments in my cadet career was being a marker for my graduation parade, and I will never forget it and the people I met. Life continued as normal when I came back. I went to work, I finished the Assassin's Creed series. Oh, and I washed my car for the first time. The only time, I think. Didn't go as well as I thought it was going to. We also hit 100 subscribers, a massive milestone that I've been trying to hit for a few years. And I have all you to thank for it, so thank you so much for helping me get to 100. Hopefully we can continue to rise as a community and become better throughout this year. After building up some solid cash, I finally decided to make my biggest investment ever into a brand new camera. The one I'm currently filming this footage on and the one I've been currently filming on for the last few months. I purchased a Canon EOS 700D with a 10-18mm for vlogging and an 18-55mm for general photography. Later down the track, I didn't realise, but I would also buy a 70-300mm for nice telephoto photography. This meant I could start doing major cinematography work, as well as filming at something higher than 480p. The step up worked. I think there was an increase in audience retention as well, so that was awesome, and I am so happy with the quality compared to my laptop cameras and my GoPro. It is 10 times better. The start of September was fast approaching, and so was my favourite event of the year apart from course, VidCon. The first ever in Australia and an amazing event where I met some of the greatest people, fans and YouTubers alike. I also got noticed for the first time. It was a little bit surreal. I had no idea how to react and kind of made a fool of myself.
I've never been noticed before, so I'm sitting there going, I don't know what to do.
I met my favourite YouTuber, Alonzo Lerone, and learnt a great deal about cinematics, which in turn led to my first real cinematic edit. I'm pretty proud of it too. Even though VidCon came to a close, I had some great memories to take with me and a year to get ready for the next one. Around the same time as VidCon, I started a brand new gaming series on the game Life is Strange Before the Storm. A game which I've absolutely fallen in love with for the reason it is so lifelike and representative of teenage turmoil. The series, though still going, has a great balancing point between the vlogging and cinematics, and I absolutely love this game. It's kind of ridiculous how much I enjoy this game. After VidCon, I went to a meeting at the Redbubble headquarters with a bunch of other Melbourne YouTubers to find out about merchandise, even though I am nowhere near close enough to do merchandise for you guys. However, it was great to meet different people and understand the process if I ever choose to do merch in the future. While there, I put together a little cinematic edit, combining stills and video to create a non-talking vlog. Bit different, but still very interesting to try my hand in and dip my foot into the water, get a feel for it. With all YouTubers, there's an editing side. I love editing, I absolutely adore it. However, what I don't adore is spending 17 hours trying to get my bloody Adobe program to work because the RAM in my computer cannot keep up. So naturally, my computer died. It sort of led into a brand new series that I thought would be pretty interesting to create for you guys, and that was The Road to My Dream Budget Setup. Budget being the key word here. I started off small. New keyboard, new mouse, and new monitor, all unboxing and reviewing them as best as I could, investing time and money on making my setup awesome. With all these unboxings, I learnt more angles and panning techniques to represent the item I was reviewing. It gave me a chance to be really creative and try different editing styles, which I enjoyed immensely. Unfortunately, life isn't always sunshine and rainbows. A dark cloud began to gather over my house and, you know, cast down its sort of terrible things that can go happen. This was when I found out that my mum was diagnosed with breast cancer. Mama Taz, damn it, why you do this? Nah, it's not her fault. You never think it would happen to you, your family, your friends. You're always just like, nah, that's not right. You think your family's immortal to this disease, and then it hits and you're sort of just sitting there going, I don't know what to do. I remember sitting on the couch with my sister and we're sitting there going, we are going to lose our mum. This is gonna happen. This is actually going to be terrible and I don't know if I can deal with that. But she pulled through, and months later, through all the chemo, she is finished with chemo and on her way to recovery. In the spirit of doing something good, I participated in my fifth Relay for Life, raising $345 for my team total of $4,000. I ran 112 laps, which smashed my goal of 100, and the whole time, all I could think about was my mum and making her proud. I'd like to thank you all for being there for me the whole way through this hardship, like I mentioned. You've all been awesome, and thank you for all your donations. Through all of this, I went to visit my mum at the Peter Mac Cancer Hospital in the city, and naturally, I took my camera.
Did I realize it was going to lead to one of my favorite cinematic edits? No. But the photos I took gave me a huge chance to explore and experiment with my camera. It was an awesome day, and getting to see Mama Taz only made it much better. Vlogs continue to roll out, some were weird, washing my dog, I mean, who does that on film? I re-uploaded the VidCon video because I accidentally deleted it. But by the time December rocked around, I had already had massive things planned. I went to my final YouTuber meetup at Fitzroy Gardens, had drinks with some mates, played some card games, and read some really bad Christmas cracker jokes. We also did some gnarly cinematic works with Kirk and Jasper. Absolutely brilliant day. The day was an awesome chance for me to reflect on everything that I'd learned throughout the year. Also, it was a great time to catch up with people and have a good old laugh just walking through Melbourne, and again, getting lost because it's my speciality. When Christmas came around, my final two vlogs of the year arose. One was DIY Christmas gifts for my family. The other video was a Christmas haul video. These two videos had two things in common: a thank you to my dad and a time for me to give back to him. So I bought him something he'd wanted for a while. Pulling resources with my mum and my sibling, we got together and bought him a drone, which I have never seen him so happy about. It was the best moment of the year, seeing my dad super excited about this flying machine. This also meant the year was coming to a close. New Year's was quiet and nothing special really happened. But what can I say? It's been a pretty special year. Good and bad, I've learnt tons, I've had a great year, and I think we've became a better community, getting better quality video and content out for all of you. Like I said, thank you so much for being here this year. The support has been amazing, and I hope that we can make 2018 as good as 2017, if not better. So thank you so much for being there. Let's kick 2018's ass. My name is Tazzy, and I am signing out. Peace, guys. Have a wonderful day. Stay savvy.
Until you find your way back home.